Let's talk a little bit about the bare filter on the sensor. So in essence, a bare filter is nothing else but different types of color filters that are above the photodiodes. And most of the time, you'll actually see two greens and a blue and a red. So this would be the four region here that represents one pixel, four another here, that represents another pixel, four here, and so on. Of course, depending on the convention of the bare filter use, sometimes you might have two reds and a green and a blue, and also two blues and a green and a red. Depends again on it, but knowing exactly what is the bare filter is essential because we need to know this to how to compute and then come up with the final image. Basically, what happens with the bare filter is each one of them lets only a specific light through. So when the light is hitting the red, basically the blue and green are prevented from going through. Red goes through. Same thing with green. Just the green goes through. Same thing with blue. Only the blue goes through. So in essence, you create three different patterns. Of course, the photodiodes then store the intensity for each and every one of them. But this coding scheme pretty much lets us know which one of the bins is actually blue, green, or red. Then, of course, it's the combination of these three channels that gives us the final image, and this is the one that we need to then decode and save for our final things. One of the questions that's important is, how is the raw input in a bare mosaic format converted to an image? What's the process to be able to then get basically the RGB color values, that is the RGB, as we've discussed when we talked about the image processing pipeline, the three channels separated out.